Finally tonight, happiness even in hard times. Turns out the feeling is contagious, and now there's science to prove it. NBC's chief medical editor, Dr. Nancy Snyderman, with news that might keep us all smiling a little longer.
What makes me happy is sleigh riding and playing with my friends in the snow.
A good meal, shelter above my head, knowing my job's in good shape, and what I do on a day in, day out basis.
One of the things that make me happy is a yo-yo.
Today's study shows happiness is contagious. It can spread from one person to another over quite a distance, and it can last for some time. But happiness isn't a solitary experience. It's dependent on others. Harvard researchers followed 4,739 people for 20 years, measuring how social networks, siblings, friends, and neighbors are affected by the happiness of others. The study controlled factors of age, gender, education, and occupation.
We found that happiness can spread like a virus through social networks. In fact, if your friend's friend's friend becomes happy, it significantly increases the chance that you'll be happy.
Researchers found close physical proximity is essential for happiness to spread. A happy friend who lives within a half mile makes you 42% more likely to be happy yourself. If that same friend lives 2 miles away, the impact drops to 22%. Happy siblings make you 14% more likely to be happy, but only if they live within a mile. Happy spouses provide an 8% boost if they live under the same roof.
The one exception, the workplace, where researchers say coworkers don't affect happiness levels. Could there be something in the environment that keeps happiness from spreading?
Past research has shown that people who are happy have healthier hearts, they have lower levels of stress hormones, and they live longer.
The best news is that happiness spreads more reliably than unhappiness, and the effects are more profound for people of the same gender. The message for all of us, happiness is infectious. The health and well-being of each and every one of us may hinge on something so profoundly basic as just being happy. Dr. Nancy Snyderman, NBC News, New York.